Hi everyone, welcome to victoriapiking.com, and today I'm going to show you how to make this amazing French lentil soup. I made it with a lot of different things inside, in particular one secret ingredient, and this is beef heart. Even though you don't have to use it, it was a great addition to the soup. So I hope you enjoy the idea and stay tuned. To the heavy bottom pot, add avocado oil. I have added about a quarter cup or so. And I'm adding first of all the onion. I chopped onion. This is pretty big onion. So I need a lot of onion here. And letting it caramelize alone for a couple of minutes. When the onion started to caramelize, I'm adding carrots and celery. And caramelizing it all together on high heat. Now add your meat after it's very well caramelized, and I'm adding chuck roast, which is beautiful, one whole one, like so. And I'm adding something weird, which is beef heart. It's very good source of protein, and it's amazing and very healthy. At this point, transfer it to slow cooker pot, all the meat and all the vegetables. I know this looks scary, trust me, but it's such a good cut of meat, and it's full of iron, so if you have iron deficiency, this is for you. All the vegetables goes in as well. And I'm going to deglaze those bits and pieces that are very tasty with water. In order to deglaze it, add a little bit of water here to the hot and take all the pieces and bits out of the bottom. And add it to the pot as well.
By the way, you can deglaze the pot with wine or stock.
Cover the meat with warm water. Now, at this point, you can cover it with broth. I like to do it with water because the meat gives so much flavor to the juices that you really don't need broth. This is actually the broth, and its make is very cheap. It's way cheaper than use already pre-made broths. To this, I'm going to add butternut squash. I'm even not bothering to peel those because you can eat peel of butternut squash. This is the only squash that you can actually peel. Eat the peel, I mean. Okay. A lot of Himalayan pink salt. This is tablespoon, so it's 3 teaspoons of Himalayan pink salt goes in. Organic no salt seasoning. It's always good. Turmeric goes in. Garlic powder. Actually, garlic powder is a little bit better in the slow cooker. It holds a little bit more flavor than the regular garlic. But you can use 4 or 5 garlic cloves easily here. And paprika. This is smoked paprika. I have quite a bit of small paprika in here. Black pepper. You have to remember, you need to place a little bit more spices in the beginning, because that by the time that it will be cooked, the spices will a little bit disappear, the flavor of it. And chili. I love these chili flakes. Couple of cloves. Don't overdo with the cloves. They're really good. 2, 3 maybe, max.
Pop lid on top and plug it on high for about 10 hours. Those are French lentils, which I soak in cold water for about 5 hours. So do it together when you put all of your soup inside. Then wash them thoroughly and add to the soup. The salt inside the soup will hold the shape of the lentils and they won't become a mush. So it's very important to salt it the soup before.
This is about 10 hours into the cooking. And about 5 hours cooking of the lentils. And it's just like fork tender. Oh, deliciousness. It's gorgeous. Need to take it all out. You see? It's just wonderful. The heart itself, it's as well fork tender, and it's just amazing. Now, you absolutely don't have to have heart, okay? But you see, this is the most gorgeous thing that I love. And the smell here is just magnificent. Now you have to see some. Look, this is just fork tender. You see? It's amazing texture. It's just wonderful. And the heart, which usually is muscle that works all the time. Look how pretty and beautiful it is inside. You see? Just amazing and soft and wonderful. And the squash is just miraculous. So everything is just awesome. And let's try our creation. This is the heart piece. It's so soft. It has this wonderful spicy flavor to it. Let's try our lentils. The smokiness, the softness of the meat, the smokiness of the paprika. Just wonderful. If you have a large family, this is exactly for you. Or you have some gathering. And if not, you can freeze it. Cook it, portion it, and freeze it, and then defreeze it in the middle of the week, and you will have perfect lunch, heartwarming lunch or dinner, and it will be amazing. So I hope you enjoyed the idea, and don't forget to subscribe, write me a comment, thumbs up me, and cheers, Victoria. Love you all. See you next time. Bye. And thank you for watching. And thank you for coming back.
Please support my channel by visiting my shops. The links are in description box below. You will find the recipes for Halloween, holidays, and just for fun. We have kids' books and game as well. Thank you for supporting me and my channel. Love you all. See you next time. Bye!